Hello students, hello everyone. So now I'm going to explain structures in C. So what are the structures? When we use the structures actually is when you want to store a different type of data, that is heterogeneous type of data into one variable or one type of data, one variables, we are going with the structures. As we have seen already, arrays are homogeneous data collection of elements where we store only same type of data elements. Whereas in structure, I will store a different type of data elements. To make it possible, we are going to use a structures. For example, in our class, a student will be there. A student will have a data to be stored for him. Roll number has to be stored, his data like marks has to be stored, and his average and phone number, address, everything has to be stored. For example, if I want to store the details of a student. Whereas a roll number is of which type? It may be the string type or it may be a integer type. Whereas his marks will be type of integer, and his average will be in terms of marks, average will be in terms of float, and his address will be in terms of string. So that is, if you want to store a one student details, I have to store these many different type of data elements into one variable. How it is possible? That is possible by structures. That is only possible by structure, by using a structures in C, by using a structures in C. So that's, we'll see how it will be there. Okay, now, so what is a structure? What is the definition of a structure? A structure is a collection of different type of elements under a same name or a single name that acts as user defined data type. See, so we have learned in the first chapter, what is the user defined data types? I said already. So I said, I'll tell you these about in the structure. So user defined types, data types are the types which are defined by the user as his own type. So by collecting some of the data variables or some of the predefined data variables, and he makes his own data type. So that is a user data type. So generally, structure used to define record in the C programming language to define a record. Record means what is a record? To set up one type of data, one place is called as a record. Structure allows us to combine elements of different data types into group. What is combines us to elements in a different type in a group. In one group, if I want to store elements of different type, I'll use with which one I'll make use of structure. The elements in this defined in the structure are called as members of structure. I'll tell you what is this members of structure when I go with how to define this. So how to define a structure, and at the time I'll tell you what is the members of a structure. So when you define a structure, you'll define int your roll number, int marks, int, everything. So for example, instead of a structure, you'll define what are the data members will be there. You'll define that data members are called as members in a structure. Okay, we'll see in the next slide. What is the next slide? How to create a structure? How to create a structure? Structure in C will be created by using a keyword called struct. How to define arrays actually? So directly we write int a of 10. So what is this int here? Int is a predefined data type. Already it is defined and you are using that data type. Where a is what? A is a identifier which is used by user, whereas 10 is the size of variables to be created. Whereas a is a variable that has to be created with which type? All these are created which type? Those only integer type. But I don't want to be create all the type of integers. Now I want to create a structure of a student where student will have his name, roll number, and average. So to store these variables, what is this first name? What is the name? Is name which type? It is an integer type. Roll number, it is a, sorry, name is a string type. Roll number is a which type? Roll number is an integer type. Where average is a float type. So to store these different type of data elements, how I can do that? I can do by defining my own data type, defining my own data type by collecting these elements. How can I do that? By using a structure. How I'll define that? The structure name, what is the name you want to give? So I'm giving a name of my structure is student. And what is the data type? What is the data type? So rule number name, here name is which type? So So which type of data type you will define it? Member one, what is the member one? Your name is a member one. Data type, another data type, rule number. How you declare rule number? Int. Int is a data type for this rule number. What is the member two? Member two is for the rule number. Likewise, how many variables, how many members to be should be there inside a structure? You define your own member, your own structure, and you use that structure as a template to define your own variables with a collection of these type of data variables. That is the structure. We'll see the difference between structure and array. What is the structure? Structure is a collection of heterogeneous. What do you mean by heterogeneous? Different type of data elements are called as heterogeneous. Homogeneous. Where array is which type? Array is a homogeneous type of elements. So array, we collect homogeneous only one type of data we are going to collect. And whereas structure will collect heterogeneous data elements. Whereas array will access by using which? Will access by using index. But here, to access the structure members, we access by using a dot operator. I said in the operators, I'll tell you what is an operator using dot operator. Dot operator access data members of a structure. To access the data members of a structure, we use dot operator. We are not seeing that this is a dot operator. So here dot, there is a dot. So that is dot operator is used to access the members of a structure. Array allocates the static memory allocation. So by using an array, I'll use a static memory allocation. By using structure, I can allocate a dynamic memory allocation. Array elements are takes less time than structure, because it is only one type and we have only one type of data and we are going to use that data. Whereas structure has multiple data elements. It is not having one element. It has to be taken what is the type of this element, type of this element, type of this element. So that's the reason it takes much time than array. So we have seen structures definition and what is the difference between array and structure. Now we'll see types of structure and how to declare that types of structure. So first, so here I've given a definition as well. So a variable are defined before they are used in the program. Structure is also defined as a declared before they are used. So that means before declaring in the structure, we have to define them. How to define? There are three different types of defining the structure. So what are they? We'll see. Okay. So how to declare and how to define them? We'll see. So first, there are three types of defining structure: target structure, and structure variable, and type define. So target structure is a structure. We have a tag name, and with this tag name, we are going to access all the structure throughout your program. Whereas structure variable are variable, you define the variables there itself only. That they are called as structure variable. Type def structure is a structure where you define by using a type def keyword. That's the reason we write type def structure. Okay. Next, we'll see tagged structure. So what is the tagged structure? So how to define a tagged structure? Structure and tag name and type 1, member 1, type 2, member 2. Type 1, member 1, type 2, member 2, and so on, how many members you define. That is called as tagged structure. That means you have a tagged name. So that's the reason we are having a tag structure. Okay, structure, tag name, type 1, member 1, type 2, member 2, and so on. So how to declare a structure? Is struct is a keyword which tells a compiler that structure is being defined. So tag name is the name of the structure, and member 1, member 2 are called as members of the structure. The members are declared within the curly braces. The close and braces must be within the semicolon. Example. What is the example he has given? So struct student char name, the int roll number, number, float average marks, and so close. So when I've told about this, so when I'm writing a structure, whenever I'm writing a structure here, don't think that it is a declaration of a structure. So when I declare, this is struct student roll number, int roll number, char name, Mach 30 and plot AVG semicolon. So here you have to be the semicolon, remember, here to this with semicolon. Struct student open brace, int is the data type for this roll number, char is the data type for the name. So name is a string, that's a collection of characters. That's the reason I've taken name of 30. So 30 characters will be there. Next, float AVG. Float AVG is average of student. So that is, don't think this is as a declaration of a structure. This is only a template. This is only template you are going to use in your program. So when I declare struct student, the student will become a data type. Struct student will become a data type. In the data type, what are the things will be there is int roll number, char name, float average. And whenever you want to declare a variable struct student st1. So when I declare st1, so here remember st1 is a variable. Remember st1 is a variable. Struct student is the data type. Struct student is the data type that you have created by using this template. Remember? So what is did you get is? So struct student is the data type. Likewise, int a is equal to 10, whereas a is a st here, a is st here, struct student is int, whereas int is predefined data type that has already created and kept we are using. But struct student is a data type you have created by using this template. That means this struct student, the structure enables you to define your own data type by using predefined data type elements which are useful to you to define your own in the program. Remember that struct is not a data type. Structure is a template where you can define your own data type by using this structure template. That means this template becomes your data type that is defined by you, that is defined by a programmer. And now I'm going to use struct student as a data type in my program, where st is a variable. Now if I write st, what is st1 is equal to st1 will have a roll number, st1 will have a name, st1 will have an average. That means st1 is a student variable, st1 roll number, st1 name, st1 average. Likewise, how many variables I want to create, that many variables I can create by using a struct student. So did you get this? Okay, for example, so here so I'm writing a struct student int roll number, char name of 30. So because I've given 30 because so it is a collection of variables, char name 30 and float AVG. Remember, so this is my structure definition only. It is not structure declaration. Remember, it is not declaration. It is only a definition so that struct student will become a data type. So this data type, by using this data type, you are going to define your own variables in your program. So that is struct student of st1 comma st2 and so on stn. That means st1 stn and so on st1, these are the variables. Whereas struct space student is a data type which you have defined by yourself, which is defined by a programmer. So what does a struct student will have? Struct student will have roll number type, name type and average type. That's it. So understand that. So struct, now we are going to define, only learn the definition of a program, not a actual definition of a structure, not actual program we are going to write. Whereas struct student, when I define a struct student, it is just data type I'm going to use. So data type I'm going to use. So char name is a variable member inside of this structure. Which structure? Student structure. Int roll number is a data member of this, which structure? Student type. Float average marks is a data type of this structure. Okay. So whenever you define this definition, no memory will be allocated until unless you have created your variables, until unless you have created variables. This is your first and foremost, you are creating first and foremost, you are creating your own definition. That's it. You are not declaring your structure. Okay, remember that. Next. So struct keyword is a tells you the compiler to being defined, structure is defined. So to tell the compiler that I'm going to define a structure, that's what the reason we are using a struct keyword. The student is an identifier, that is your own identifier. What the name you want to keep, you can keep your own identifier, and that becomes your tag name. That means that becomes your tag name. Struct student is your data type. So tag name, and it is a tag name. A roll number, name, roll number, average marks are the structure variables. They are members, not variables. They are members. They are not the variables, they are members. And whenever I create a variable with the struct student, all the variables, these members will become a variable values to that particular variable. Okay, see here. So how to declare that struct tag name, variable var1, var2, and so on. See here. So as I said, so var1, var2. So var1, var2. So these are structs st1, st2, st3 are the var1, var2, var3. So what is the tag name here? Struct student. Struct is a keyword and student is a tag name I've created. So this is to define, that is declare, sorry. This is to declare your declaration, that is structure declaration. So whenever you create, when you declare struct student of st1, st2 and so on, at that time only memory will be allocated and the variable values for this st1, st2 and stn, the values will be allocated with the roll number, name, average. That means st1 will have a roll number, name, average, st2 will have a roll number, name, average, stn will have a roll number, name, average. That means, so I'm only defining my own template, and by using this template I'm defining my declaring my variables. That is the thing about your structure. Okay, so next, struct. So example he has given is struct student st1. Struct student st1, memory is allocated for which variable? S1. So as for S1, variable will be created. What are the things which has been created? Name, for name. So what are the things are there here? So in the structure, name is there, roll number is there, and average marks also is there. So for that, how a memory will be allocated? So name for 10 bytes. So as I've taken it is name as 10 here. What is the 10? 10, 10, 10. So each character takes 1 byte, each of 10 bytes. Okay, roll number, so byte, it is 2 byte memory. So it is 16 bit architecture, I have given 2 bytes. If at all it is a 8 bit architecture, it will be 32 bit architecture, it will be 4 bytes. Okay, next, average marks will store. So how many bytes? 4 bytes. That means ST1 have how many memory allocation, how much memory allocation will be allocated? 10 plus 2 plus 4. The total, how many bytes? 16 bytes of memory will be allocated once I declared the S1. So this is a declaration of your structure. Remember, struct student S1 is a declaration of your declaration. So structure student 1, S1. S1 is a declaration. Okay, next, the number of bytes will be allocated is 16, as I said. So 10 plus 2 plus 4. So that is about your tagged structure. Tagged structure is you're declaring tag here. You're declaring a tag here and you're writing a tag, and by this tag you're defining your structure. That's the reason we are calling it as tagged structure. Next, I'll go with another type. What is that another type? Structure variable. That means the same as tagged structure, only we have a tag name, but the variable will be declared here itself. So here we have a semicolon. So only we defined a definition here and we have closed with a semicolon, and after that, so we have defined we have declared our own declaration somewhere whenever I want to declare. But here the tagged, this is a tagged structure, but here in the structure variable I define my data, that is define my structure here and declare my variable here only. I declare my variables here only. That's the reason I am writing it as structure variable. Okay, next, what is this struct is for the keyword for declaring a structure. You know that. So tag name is a tag name to write every identifier to be written for the structure. Member 1, type 1, member 1, type 2, member 2, and so on. How many members you have? That means, for example, student will have a name, roll number, average likewise. If at all, if I take employee, employee will have employee ID, employee name, and salary likewise. And if at all, if I take a movie, movie name, movie will have a number of frames and number of duration and what are the cast. So that will be members inside of a structure. That means if you take one, any type of thing. So for example, if I take a student, that is a student for a student will have a roll number, name, and that will be the members for the that student type. If I take a movie, in that movie, what will be there int duration, that is time, so date, time, likewise. So that members will be there for the movie. If I take a employee, employee will have employee ID, so employee number, so employee, likewise, that will have a employee structure, will have a that type of members. If I take a book, book will have a members of pages, number of pages, author, and that will have a book, will have a that type of members. So that means what the members to be defined, that is your choice, but you are defining your own type by using a structure. That's it. And after that, you can use any of these types. So sir, which type we have to use to define your structure? Any of these three types you can define by using these three types. Okay, that is your choice. You can define by your target structure, you can define by your structure variable, you can define by your type defined member type. So based upon which thing is suitable, you can use that in that of three. Okay, the next step. So example, what is the example here? Struct student, care name 10, int roll number, float average mark, same thing, same members, and but have defined my variable here. That means here, in that case, in before case, I have defined separately by taking a struct student s1. So differently defining, so they, whereas here I define this definition, and after that definition defining, so where I want to declare, I can declare struct tag name and variable member, variable number, struct student name s1. So but means I have to repeat struct student and s1. But whereas here only I am defining my data type, that is structure definition, and here only declaring my variable. So whereas s1 is a variable for this structure student. Okay, s1 will have name, roll number, average marks. Okay, so here I would declare two or more. So the s1 is one type of student, s2 is another type of student. How much memory is allocated for this s1? For s1 it will be same as 16, s2 it will be 16. For each variable we'll allocate how many member of variables will be there, how many member variables will be there, that much member bytes will be allocated for each variable that I've created inside of a structure. Okay, next I'll see a, we'll see a type def structure. Type def structure is same as structure variables. So but what is the difference is you define here type def by using a type def. So structure type def struct, and you write a type ID, which type of, that is here type ID is your tag name. So here we have given a tag name here separately, but here in a type def. So we have given type def struct and type 1 member 1, type 2 member 2, but I have given here type name of this structure by using a type ID. You can given your own name. This is a type ID, is an identifier that you can choose your own thing. So remember, type def is a keyword to define your own data type. That is, you can change your predefined data type to your own type. That's a type def useful. Whenever useful is, type def is useful to define your own data type by predefined data type. So type def is also one of the keyword. So type def is keyword, as well as structure is also another keyword. Structure is keyword to define your structure, whereas type def is to define your own data type by using a predefined data type. So type 1 member 1, type 2 member 2, and so on. Type ID, so type ID is your identifier, your name, which name you want to give this for this definition, you have to give your type ID, that is an identifier. See how I have defined type def structure, care name, same members I have defined, but here I have given a name here. So instead of giving here struct student, here I have given type def struct, and here I have given student. That's the difference. So this is only a definition, remember, this is only definition or template I have defined. Remember, up to now I have defined three things. What are the three things I have defined? I have told you definitions of your structure. What are the things? First one is tag structure, structure variable, and type defined. The type defined structure. These three types are only to define your own template of your structure, not declaration. This is only to define your template. That means you want to create your own data type. You're going to create your own data type by using your members. What are the members to be collected by yourself to be there in your variable, that they are the collection. You're making that collection and you're creating your own variable by using a structure. That's it. So these three types are definition types of defining your own. These three types are defining your own structure variable, structure members, structure definition. Okay, remember this. Whenever you define your structure template or structure definition, no memory allocation will be done until unless you declare your variables to the structure. You declare your variables to a structure. How to declare variables to a structure? Same structure here. So by declaration is different here. What is, how I am declaring? No need to write the structure. Structure student one s one s one. So that is the difference for the declaration of first one tag structure and structure type def structure. Okay, I'll see what I'll make you differences between defining structure. First one tag structure. Tag structure, how to define tag structure? Structure, your name of your structure and members, data members. For example, int roll number. I'm writing roll. Okay, so float avg and char name. You can take any type of things however you want, which order you want, you can take in that order. No need to mention the same order also. Okay, so they will be defined once you define here. So I'm taking 30 is my size. So whenever I define this, this is only definition of a structure. But to declare the structure, how to declare again? Struct student s1 s2 and s3 and so on. So this is a declaration, this is definition, this is declaration, this is definition, and this is declaration. So this is declaration of your structure, this is definition of your structure. You are given a template, that's it. Up to this you are given template, after this you are defining your structure. Whereas structure variable, how to define structure variable? Same as tag structure, same thing will be repeated. Struct student open brace int roll number char name thirty and float average, as you wish. In which order you want to declare, you can declare. Same thing, semicolon. Okay, close. But here separately I declared my variables, but here itself only I'll declare my variables. That's it. That is the difference between tag structure and structure variable. Whereas type def type, for this type def type, what I will declare is, I write a type def by using type def and struct open brace and variables members I'll write members and close semicolon, here only semicolon. And whenever I declare, how to declare? By using only this name, no need to write again struct student s1 s2 and so on. This is the thing, this is the difference between these three type of definitions. Okay, so these are the definitions of defining your own structure members. Okay, so next we'll see how to initialize the structure. Structure tag name variable is equal to value 1, value 2 and so on, value n. For example, if I have, so my structure have name, roll number, average. So I'm writing s1. Where is s1 is my variable name. So first one s1 will have what? S1 will have a name, s1 will have a roll number, s1 will have a average. Which order it is there? The same order you have to define. First it is name, so I define in the double quotes, because every string should be in the double quotes. Next s1 rule number is 10, I've given a 10. So next average, my average is 67.8. this is a float type, that's it. So this is only initializing. So you are assigning a value here itself. If you want to assign a value here itself, you assign. So what is the memory, how it is memory created here? See here, first up to this is a name. So how many bytes for this name? Six bytes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bytes. So every string will be ending with a /0. That's the reason I've given. Next 10. To store 10, how many bytes? 4 bytes. This is 4 bytes. Next 67.8. It is also 4 bytes. Total 6 plus 4 plus 4. 14 bytes of memory will be allocated once I've initialized or declare the variable. Okay, next. Initialize during the structure declaration. Structure declaration, this is structure declaration, whenever structure declaration. So after, so this is, I have defined the structure separately somewhere in the before or somewhere. And after that, I am declaring the structure. So here, this is same way. Here I have defined and here is I am initializing. So whereas here, I defined somewhere and I am declaring somewhere and initializing values. This is another way. So same thing, initialization is same thing. So we have to follow same rule, but here the variable has defined here, the variable has declared here, and the variable is declared separately. That's it. Okay, points to be remember. See, so these are members of the structures cannot be initialized in the structure definition, should not initialize here. Struct s is my tag name. For example, struct char name is equal to char name of 10 is equal to Shiva. This is to not be done. So here only should not define. So here only should not initialize, because so it is not the variable. These are not the variables. Which is the variable? S1 is the variable. S1 will have a name, roll number, average. That's the reason we should not initialize here in the structure members, inside of your structure member. After declaring only variable only, you have to initialize the variables, initialize the values. Okay, remember that. Okay, you can also define separately one by one. How to define that, we'll see that. Accessing a structure member, how to access a structure member? Dot operator, by using which operator? Dot operator. By using a dot operator, we have to access that particular variable by using C. For example, I would initialize the values. See, I define my own structure. So what is the structure name? Student is my structure name. Struct student is my structure name. Structure members are char name of 6 into roll number, float average, and closed off. So but I've also initialized the variables here. What is the variable name? S1 is my variable name. I've initialized that. S1 to Shiva is the name of my student, and 10 is the roll number, and S2. And next one is 67.8 is the average of this student. Whereas if I want to access each member at a time, so each member, one member at a time, how I can do that? S1 dot name is the Shiva. S1 dot roll number is 10. S1 dot average is 67.8. Whereas S1, for S1 I have assigned these values. S1, for S1 I have assigned these values. For S1, I have assigned these values. For S1, I have assigned these values. But this is which one? This is a name. This is roll number. This is average. That's the reason to access each member at a time. S1 dot name, S1 dot roll number, S1 dot average. This by this using, so we are going to access each member. Okay? Remember. So